acting like I'm hassling hard. Can't ignore them. Going for your missions like I grabbed a board. Water agents paranoid, so much back and forth. I touched down in New York, Eli Manning boy. All my life I got off on the 13th floor. Grateful for these blessings till I'm seeing plenty more, that's for sure. I'm showing it like side. Came out of mud, the diamond and rub, just give me a wipe down, yeah. Shining bright until the lights turn out. Salute me when you see me, man. Salute me when you see me, goddamn. The pain made me everything I am. Hey. Took everything I got, right up to the top. The pain made me everything I am. Took everything I got, right up to the top. Hey, you ain't got the bandwidth to handle this. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this, nah. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this, nah. Well spoken for a black man. That's how you serve a compliment with your backhand. A routine stop, ain't no talking back. Save your breath, keep it 2 cents and invest in the dash can. I've been a menace back when, sleeping on me with the snack camp. Keep it G, would you rather be a never was or a has been? I put it down with a tile on it, ain't had the wall of the house on it. I'm looking down but I never look down on it. I put a crown on it, yeah. The kids are bad, the money is long, the head is good. The future's bright, the ground is heavy, the dash is wood grain. A long way from young, girl misunderstood. A long way from home, strong, high, still tight. Showing it like side. Came out of mud, the diamond and rub, just give me a wipe down, yeah. Shining bright until the lights turn down. Salute me when you see me, man. Salute me when you see me, goddamn. The pain made me everything I am. Took everything I got, right up to the top. The pain made me everything I am. Took everything I got, right up to the top. Ayy, you ain't got the bandwidth to handle this. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this, no. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this, no.
Y'all, Grand Rising, Grand Rising. When it comes to the day, I hope y'all had a great weekend. Hope you started your day off right. If you ain't on something good, you need to get up off of it. Get up off of it. Come on up out of there. I don't care what you've been through. I don't care what you're going through. I mean, when I say I don't care, I mean it's not that important for you to just waste time and focus on things that don't matter. As Lauryn Hill says, nothing even matters at all. No, if you can't change it or you can't control it and it's affecting you in a negative way, you gotta let it go. So some people, you just gotta learn how to let it go. Certain people, places, and things, you just gotta let it go. You gotta let it go. Cause I'm gonna tell you, before you tear you down, you need to let go certain people, places, and things for the sake of mental clarity, health, spiritual stability, the opportunity for more joy, peace, happiness, tranquility. What you on this morning? What you on this Grand Rising Day? It's brand new. Anything new means there's great possibilities, great opportunities. You don't know what can happen in this day. Today could be one of the best days of your life. With a good mind, a healthy mind, a healthy heart, a healthy spirit. Every day ain't gonna always be peaches and cream. We understand this. But life is what you make it. It's what you make it. It's what you make it. So God wants us to be better artists. We need to come with a better mind frame, a better heart, a better soul. Get something better. Align yourself with something better for your spirit, for your mental clarity. You can't even see life clear. Or you can't even see life clear to a point you are better than blessed. It's because your mind is so corroded with so many bad thoughts. Some your thought pattern and thought process is flawed. You can literally think yourself into a blessing. Some people don't even realize the power God has already given them to be a visionary or to be virtuous. Well, literally, you can pray, think, or move into a healthy way, into a healthy headspace. You can literally put yourself or align yourself into the right direction for a big blessing or that very thing that you've been needing or desiring out of your mind, heart, body, and soul. It's in your thought process. It's in your thought pattern. What does your pattern show this morning? A lot of you, how you came into today is a reflection of your weekend. Maybe you didn't treat your weekend right. So your weekend became weakened. It was weak. It wasn't strong. Because the way you know it ain't strong by how you came and thought you was going to approach this Monday. Y'all got to do better than what you're doing. It ain't enough to get you to where you desire to be. It ain't enough to have what you've been desiring to have. It ain't enough to go where you've been desiring to go. God said, I need more. You can't just keep doing the same thing and expecting a different result. That is insanity. That makes you insane. When you have a mentality to expect more, but not do more or do different. Speak, God. Speak. Speak. You cannot expect more or different if you're going to give the same thing. You got to come out of that disposition. That mentality, that how you function. Anything new gonna require something new out of you. I said anything new is going to require something new out of you. So my question in this moment is, what are you willing to give or bring to the table of life today? We can't talk about yesterday. It's gone. It's a wrap. We can't talk about last week. It's gone. It's a wrap. We can't talk about the past. It's gone. It's a wrap. All we can talk about, we can't even talk about the future. The future will take care of itself when it gets here. I'm talking about now. The N-O-W. The right now. What are you willing to bring to the table of life right now? That's what matters. That will give us great clarity of your past. But that also will give us great clarity of where you're going. Your future. By what you do right now. I'm concerned about your now because I'm going to tell you something right now. If the enemy has ever been concerned about something, the enemy is not concerned about your past or your future. Your enemy is concerned about your now. Come on, speak, God. Speak. 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 The enemy is concerned about your now. Because what you do right now is going to tell us a lot about what you did in your past or what happened to you in your past. What you do right now is going to be a reflection and give us great intel of what your future is going to be like. So I'm concerned about your now. What are you willing to do right now? Right now is going to tell me all I need to know. What you about to do, how you about to do it, if you gonna be able to do it. I'm concerned about your now. The most important piece of your life right now is your now. Is your now. Not your past, not your future, but your now. You need to be concerned about your now. Because this gonna tell where you're going. If you're gonna get there. If it's even possible. You're now. So what are you bringing to the table of life this morning? How did you get out the bed this morning? If you got off on the wrong side of the bed, you need to get back in the bed and get off on the right side. Get off on the opposite side. Start all over. Renew your mind, heart, body, and soul because today is new and anything new is going to require something new out of you. All today is saying, don't come at me with yesterday's behavior. Yesterday's thought pattern, thought process, that was yesterday's frequency. No, today wants you to bring something new, which is newness. Newness aligned to now. Now wants something new. So what are you willing to bring to the table of life? Today is your day. Have it your way. It's going to come. Your success today is contingent upon your thought process, your thought pattern. And the very decisions you are willing to make right now. Some of you, all you need to do is just simply smile. smile, compliment your temple, which is your mind, heart, body, and soul. Compliment it. Just compliment it. Just compliment it in a vigorous way, in a positive way. Just compliment it. Yeah. 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 You only got one life to live. And when the elders said life is short and full of trouble, they was talking about people who don't respect life and don't know how to live life the right way. The elders said life is short and full of trouble. They wasn't talking about people that are living right or taking a righteous path. They were talking about the people who they looked at what they were doing in the now. What they were doing in the now told them everything they need to know about their future is going to be short-lived. Baby, if you don't change, the grave going to be await you. Baby, if you don't turn from the area ways, you're going to jail. Baby, if you don't change the way you take care of your body, you're going to be in the hospital. All the elder was projecting. They could see where you're going because they didn't took more steps than you. That's what the elders were saying. Life is short and full of trouble. What was the elders saying? The elders were simply just saying, hey, they was talking to the people who don't respect life. They were talking to the people who don't understand life, principles, values, universal laws. What up, Sunshine? Blessed to you, Queen. It's Motivation Monday, Miracle Monday, Motivation Monday. I'm going to tell you right now, that's all the elders were saying. Hey, life is short and full of trouble. They were talking to the people who don't respect life, folk who don't live life properly, folk who waste their time focusing on things they cannot control or change, folk who know better but don't do better, folk who align themselves with negative people, folk who don't protect their energy or their spirit, folk who don't go where they're loved, elevated, celebrated, or motivated, folk who don't turn from the error of their ways, folk who walking with the wrong crowd. Yeah, life is short and full of trouble if you're going to make these dumb decisions. But what the elder was saying, hey, when you live a good life, a positive life, a right, take the righteous path, life is long. No matter what age you die, you can leave the world at 23 and it can be the longest 23 years you ever lived. Life is long. It's all about perspective. But when the elders said that life is short and full of trouble, they was talking about the people who was going down the wrong path. You took the wrong path. It wasn't the righteous path. You didn't take the righteous path. You took the devil's path. Oh, yeah. The elders saying, yeah, when you took that path, oh, yeah, your life going to be short-lived. 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 Very short-lived. That is the reality. That is the reality. The reality is if you don't make better choices, conscious decisions for what's best for your life today, your future is not going to be bright. So the reality is, I'm not concerned about your past. I'm not even concerned about your future. I'm concerned about your now. God wants us to be more attentive, focusing on what we're doing right now, because it tells us what your past looked like, and it also gives us great intel of what your future gonna look like by what you do right now. How you woke up, your plans for the week, what are you willing to do on Monday, what are you willing to sacrifice on Tuesday, your now. You need to be more concerned about your now. The more you be concerned about your now, you're going to make some great decisions that's going to propel you spiritually, physically, emotionally, sexually, financially, every entity of your life. If you get more serious about your now, come on, speak, God, speak. If the devil is going to attack you, he is not going to go back to your past. He is not going to go in your future. He is going to cause more hiccups in your now, because your now can cause more conflict to where you're going, if you even get there. So y'all need to be more conscious about your now, because if you don't care about your now, the enemy sure will. The enemy will conflict. The enemy will block you. The enemy will distress you. The enemy will get you off your rocker. The enemy will keep you from some of the greatest moments of your life. The enemy will deceive you mentally. All it takes is a thought to get you off your rocker. And now what was godly intended for you, you won't receive it, all because you don't believe. You simply don't believe. You've walked away from your belief mechanism, meaning the power of thought that aligns in your brain, in your head, all because you wasn't concerned about your now. Come on, speak, God. Speak. You wasn't concerned about your now. Some of y'all live more of your life just going through the motion. You cannot expect to be successful with no planning or preparation. No planning and no preparation, you cannot get nothing done. Y'all got to stop just going through the motion. You got to plan and prepare. When things come into my day and in my life that I prayed for or I desired, I expected to come. I'm not shocked that it came. This was plans and preparation. Plans and preparation. I anticipated this. I am not shocked that it came. I planned. I prepared. I visualized it. I expected to come. When y'all are always shocked and surprised, it's because you're not planning and you're not preparing. Oh, I can't believe this happened to me. Or, man, this is crazy. This happened. Yeah, you don't plan and prepare. Sometimes God will give you unscheduled blessing just to show you that you need to get into planning and preparation mode. Planning and preparation mode. Why? Because God is, he'll give you an unscheduled blessing just to show you that you could have had this long time ago. You could have been had this. But the reason why you couldn't have this is because of your mind. Your mind wasn't healthy. Some of y'all desire certain things right now, but you got to have a mind for it. Come on, speak, God. It got to be into your intellect. It got to be in your mind frame. It got to be in your consciousness. Even push it back to your sub so you can bring it back to your consciousness to remind you of the things you desire and the things you prayed for. Yeah. Speak, God. Speak. Because the reality is you can have whatever you want to have out of this life. You can have whatever you want to have out of this life. It's in your belief mechanism, your temple. Temple here, temple here. This is where God should be. It's a mentality. You can think yourself until it is. What wasn't can become what is if you believe. It's in your thought pattern. You got to get it in your eye. The eye is the light to the soul. The heart gives you emotions, which aligns to a drive. Your spirit gives you enlightenment, meaning courage to keep going and never give up. So if you can't be, you can't be nothing you can't see. If you can't see yourself having it, then don't have no expectations, because poor expectations lead to great disappointments. It's because there was no planning and no preparation. Come on, speak, God, speak. Yes, Miracle Monday, Motivation Monday, Manifestation Monday. Y'all got to come correct with the things you want out of this life. You should want a lot of things out of this life. You should want a lot of things out of this life, because you can have whatever you have, and it starts right here. Right here. If you don't have it or you didn't receive it, it's because you truly didn't want it. Because still remaining the same up to this date today, There is not one thing that I did not desire. I did not want. My heart didn't pant after. My mind didn't think of it. My spirit didn't encourage me to get it. That I did not receive. There is not one thing that I wanted out of this life that I did not receive. If I was seriously, seriously devoted to getting it. Not one. Not one. So if you don't have something you desire, I'm going to question how bad you really want it. How bad do you really want it? Because when you take the steps, baby, when you make the sacrifices, baby, when you pray, baby, when you can see, you visualize that thing, baby, I'm telling you, it's coming to fruition. You got to be willing to take the steps and be consistent. The devil is robbing you out of your nows. Come on, speak, God. Speak, God. Speak. The devil is robbing you out of your nows because you're so caught up from in your past. Come on, speak, God. You're so caught up in your future that you abandoned your now. God wants you to come back. Come back to your now. God wants you to come back to your now because you ain't giving enough service. You ain't doing enough praying. You ain't doing enough meditation. You ain't doing enough planning and preparation in your now. The devil got you caught up in your past, what you've been through, what you've been going through. That's why you can't enjoy today. The devil got you looking so far forward that you didn't even realize to get there. To get where you're going, you got to do what you need to do today. You so caught up in past and future that you abandoned your now. Come on, speak, God. God said, come back to your now. It's your now that you forgot about. It's your now that you are allowing the devil to rob you from. I don't care what you've been through. I don't care what you're going through. You need to focus more on your now and become more militant and do what you need to do so you can get what you desire, what you truly want. God said you want it. Show me. Show me in your todays. Because what you do today can tell where you're going tomorrow. If you even see tomorrow. It's your now. The most important part of your life is the now. Not the past, not the future. It's your now. So when you get more serious about your now, God gonna get more serious with you. I've seen the handworks of the Most High work in my favor. By just a few sacrifices, being militant, holding my spirit, holding my tongue, controlling my anger, disassociating, separating, going where I'm motivated, going where I'm elevated, going where I'm loved, just making a few great choices, not going certain places, making certain sacrifices. I was concerned about my now. I said, I got to get serious about my now to be able to get where I desire to be. Y'all better start working on your now. I don't care what you've been through. If you ain't get up on the right side of the bed, if you ain't smiled yet, if you ain't feeling excited about today, you need to change the era of your ways. Stop getting up like that. Tap into some things that's going to motivate you, educate you, elevate your mind, heart, body, and soul. Y'all got to start in tuning yourself with things that's going to bring the best out of you and not the worst. I'm concerned about your now because your now tells me where you came from. And your now will tell me where you're going. What are you willing and prepared to do now? Now. For what's best for you and your family. What's best for you and your life. What's best for the things you desire. The things you've been wanting. The things you've been praying for. The things you've been wanting to come to pass. Or you've been wanting to receive. What are you willing to do? I'm concerned about your now. Your now is so important. Your now is so important, more important to you than you even realize it. The devil wants to keep you out of the middle. Because the middle is the core, it's the nucleus. Your middle is the now. On the left is your past. On the right is your future. God said, get more focused on the middle. That's the now, today. What are you willing to do today? I know you got stuff you got to do all week. I know you got stuff you got to do tomorrow. But your center focus today, baby. Your center focus today got to be on the now. Oh, I could focus on that past. But that past can be dark in certain areas. So I'm not going to set back my spirit. Think about stuff that don't even matter. Think about stuff I can't change. Think about stuff I can't control. I can't dwell so much in my future because I can get lost in the sauce. See, when you dwell so much into your futures, speak God, you start to develop a mentality of fantasy, and you can get lost in the sauce. You can go away from your reality. You can start dreaming and never wake up from it, just to actually experience. See, that's why you can't get so caught up in your future, but you need to focus in your now, because what you do today will determine your tomorrows. Come on, speak God, speak. I'm concerned about your now. What are you willing to do right now? What are you doing right now? How did you wake up right now? I'm telling you, what are you planning to do with this week that's going to make the future you look back at the you of you today and say thank you? I need to know, what are you prepared to do right now? Some of you, you need to change your countenance. How you been feeling? How you been viewing life? How you been operating with certain people? Sometimes you got to fall back. Sometimes you got to create space. Sometimes you got to love people from a distance. I'm concerned about your now. Some of you ain't happy because of who you aligned to or who you're tied to, who you've been dealing with. Sometimes you got to create some space, and space don't do nothing. Have you ever heard when we was young and you would see two grown people fight, or even teenagers, they would say, yeah, baby, we ain't got nothing but space and opportunity. They would square up and be like, yo, man, we ain't got nothing but space and opportunity. What's up? When we were hand box and fight, ain't nothing but space and opportunity. When one creates space between somebody that they are aligned to, come on, speak, God. Speak, God. When one creates space from something that is negative, something that is distracting, something that is of hindrance. When one creates space, meaning love somebody from a distance, separate, disassociate, relocate. When you create space, therefore you make more opportunity. This is the reason why when people would box, or people would slap box, or people would even fight, they would say, oh man, oh, you want to fight? You want to do this? Ain't nothing but space and opportunity. Why? Because when you create space, you can square up. You can view life the way you need to be. You can know if you need to jab left or swing right. You can see more opportunity. So when you are dealing with certain people, places, and things that are hazardous to your development, your self-growth, your self-worth, I'm telling you, block you from your blessings, being nothing but a distraction, being of great hindrance, create space. Space can lead to opportunity. These opportunities can be of a new person to take some of their time. This opportunity can be opportunity for you to work on yourself. This space and opportunity can be opportunity for more blessings to come, because sometimes you fail to realize that God don't bless in no mess. Meaning, before God blesses you, God the Most High looks how you're functioning in you, and God also looks who you're aligned to, who you're tied to. So when you create space from somebody that is a great hindrance, you create opportunity for change, love. I'm telling you, blessings on top of blessings, assurance, greater things to come. Greater things to have, space and opportunity. I'm concerned about your now. What you do right now going to tell me where you came from. What you do right now going to tell me where you going. So you need to be concerned about your now. I'm concerned about your now. What are you doing right now? What your desires and aspirations goes, what are you willing to do? It's the will. It's the will. Meaning, are you willing to do what is necessary for what's best for you and your life going forward? The devil is robbing you out of your now, because some of you, y'all are lost in your past because you ain't got over some stuff. You ain't got over some mess. Those who love and support me, like and share. Like and share. And if God put it on your heart, hey, bless my business, my Venmo, my Cash App is in the title. But I'm going to tell you, the devil is robbing you out of your now. You ain't spending enough time in your nows, your N-O-Ws. You're not spending enough time in your nows. Some of y'all still being hung up in your past because you haven't made peace with it. As long as you don't make peace with certain negative situations in your past, it's going to stay alive. God said you need to bury that. That thing needs to die. That means you need to make peace with it. That's why when they tell you to rest, or when they say rest in peace, that means you make closure. That means you create closure. Speak, God. You make a closure with that life or existence or relationship you had with that individual. God said, how do you know how to rest in peace when people die, but yet you don't know how to rest in peace when it comes to certain situations? How? God said, I know you know how to rest in peace because when certain people die, you send them on. You create closure. There is an exit. You do it physically, but why can't you do it spiritually? You still caught up in your past. You still caught up on what they said. You still caught up in what certain people have done. Why? Because the devil is robbing you from your now. Some of you that are under the sound of my voice right now, you so caught up in your past, you can't even enjoy today. And today is a blessed day. Today is a new day. Today is a prospering day. Today is a glorious day. And I'm telling you right now, if you change your mind, today can be one of the best days of your life. You being robbed out of your now by staying caught up in your past. You're going to have to grow up and make peace with what you've been through, what you're going through, so you can enjoy what's in front of you. Come on, speak, God. Speak. Speak. You're going to have to make peace with what you're going through, what you've been through, so you can embrace and enjoy what God has prepared in front of you. Y'all got to let certain things go, because if you can't change it, you can't control it, you out of your jurisdiction, you got to learn how to let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go. Because it's doing a disservice for what's to come. Your growth, your self-development. Some of you are caught up in your past. Meanwhile, the negative things that have hurt you or deceived you from your past has moved on. But you still caught up with it. 6 months, 5 years, 10 years, still think about that thing, because you haven't spiritually developed to a level to grow up, to affect your physical state, where you make peace with what you've been through, what you're going through, so you can embrace the table that God has prepared before you, in front of you. Y'all got to make peace with certain things, because the devil is robbing you from your now. Some of you, the devil is robbing you from your now because you're so caught up in your future. And the reality is, you're so caught up on a thing that you might not never see. It might not never be, because you're being robbed out of your now. If one gets so caught up in their future, not only will you abandon your todays, but you will get robbed for more days to come. Because when you are caught up in your future, you get caught up too much. You create a fantasy. Your whole life is made up in your head, and it's so far from your reality. Y'all don't get so caught up in your future that you create a fantasy. This will draw you further away from your reality. What up, Jebo? What up, King Grand Rising? Today going to be a blessed day. Y'all, don't get so caught up in your future. You will rob yourself from your reality because you will get more caught up in a fantasy. Fantasy. You are a fan of something you will never see. Come on, speak, God. Speak. Speak, God. Fantasy. You are a fan of something you will never see. Because if you don't get caught up on your nows, you will never get to see where you're going. Come on, speak, God. Speak. 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 The devil is robbing y'all out of your now. What are you willing to do now? What are you willing to sacrifice now? What are you willing to change now? If you want what you want, your desires, your aspirations, your goals, you need to get more serious in your nows. Come up off that past. Come up off that future so much. The only time you go left and right is when you're going to pick up something that's going to propel you in your nows. God said that's wisdom. Wisdom. The only time you go in your past is if you're going to pick up something that's going to help you in your future or in your todays. The only time you go into your future is when you're looking forward to something so it's going to reflect or inspire you to make conscious decisions right now to help you going forward. It's your nows. Your NOWs. You so caught up in the past that you can't even embrace the blessing you got today. You so caught up in your future that you abandoned your nows so that you will never get to where you desire. You're too left and right. Wisdom says you're too left. You're too right. God said, come back home to the middle. Come back to the core. Come back to the nucleus. Stand on your nows. Because what you do today is going to tell me where you came from. What you do today is going to tell me where you're going. Those who love and support me, like and share. Like and share. If God put it in your heart, bless my Venmo, my Cash App, inspire you some type of way. But I need you to come back home. Come back home. The devil is robbing you out of your nows. Your nows are so important. Your NOWs. You're so caught up in your past that you can't even see what's in front of you. If you stay in your past moving forward in life, you're going to trip. You're going to trip going forward, staying in your past because you're not looking ahead. This is how the devil deceives us, by dwelling and thinking about things we cannot change, nor can we control because we're so caught up in our past. You got to make peace with these things so they don't become hiccups in your growth, your development, how you approach life today. A lot of you, if you wake up on the wrong side of the bed or you just wake up with a low energy, low frequency, it's only because you're still dwelling in something that happened yesterday or something that happened in your past. Y'all got to have more self-control. The mental and spiritual ability to control thyself. Self-control. Controlling thyself for what's best for you today that is going to be healthy for you tomorrow. It's your nows. It's your nows. Y'all need to make more peace with your past. Y'all need to be conscious of how much time you spend looking forward in your future. Past come with hiccups, setbacks. Future creates fantasies of becoming a fan to something you will never see because you abandoned your nows. It abandons your reality. Meaning life to you looks like a video game versus something real. Y'all better wake up. Get back to your nows. And make it your mission today to live one of the best days you ever live. Let's go. Let's go. Because you only got one life to live. And I'm going to tell you what you do today is going to determine where you came from. Let me know where you came from and give me great intel of where you're going. Where you're headed in life. So every day that God gives you, you need to be asking yourself, okay, what do I need to do today? Because if I do what I need to do, It's going to give me the opportunity to be able to do what I want to do. Come on, speak. God, that felt so good to me. That felt so good to me. Excuse me. That felt so good to me. That energy was good. If I can bag that energy up and put it on aisle 7 in Walmart, that energy was that would sell out. It would sell out. I said, if you wake up every day in your nows doing what you need to do, this will put you in position to be able to do what you want to do in life. The need comes before the want. Some of y'all, the reason why your life is in disarray, the reason why you can't do what you desire to be, is because you put your wants before your needs. If you just simply in today do what you need to do, this will put you in position to do what you want to do when it comes to your life. This is nothing but business before pleasure. In my house, there is no pleasure before business. The only thing that's PB is peanut butter and jelly in my house. Everybody knows that you got to handle your business before you can have leisure or pleasurable time. My son knows on Sunday night, the garbage can needs to go to the end of the driveway. I can't sit here and come downstairs and see you playing video games or in your room playing video games, doing all this leisure time that you love to do, and your business is not handled. It's always business before pleasure. Because when you do what you need to do in life, it puts you in position. It gives you options. It gives you opportunity to do what you want to do in life. Life is about sacrifices. What are you willing to sacrifice this morning to put yourself in a better position? Your family in a better position? What conversations are you willing to have with your mate, your family, your friends, your job associates? I mean, your partner, whoever, however. What are you willing to do today that's going to complement your future? I need you to make some decisions today that's going to make the future you look back at the you of you today and say, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. This is high-level responsibilities. I always say at the end of my life, you ain't on my life for me. This ain't about me. This is bigger than me. I'm just a servant. I'm just doing my job. I'll just make this a mission, man. I want you to live your best life before you die, because you're going to die. You're going to leave one day. It could be today. But I'm telling you right now, your nows are so important. Your NOWs. Your NOWs are so important. Not your past. Your past don't carry more weight than your now. Your future don't carry more weight than your now. Your nows are important. It's invaluable. It's valuable. It's today. It's your best gift you could have ever gotten today. Today is your day. Today is your day. You gotta say it till you feel it. Say it till you mean it. Today is your day. Today can be one of the best days of your life if you focus on your NOWs, your nows, your nows. Yeah, you came on my block. I pray and hope that something I said have motivated you in some type of way to get your life together, realign yourself to what you need to do so you can start doing what you want to do with your life by a few conscious decisions. Love yourself more, enough to put yourself in position not to just better yourself, but better also the people that you're tied to. I always say at the end of my life is peace and love. Peace and love. A man functions off peace, a woman functions off love. I say this at the end of all of my lives because I want y'all to respect this man and woman thing, because I want y'all to stop having hiccups. The more you learn how to work with the opposite sex, the more healthier, more successful your life is going to be. A man functions off peace. If you take that man peace, he's going to look for peace in some other person, place, or thing. A woman functions off love. If you play with her love, she's going to seek love in some other person, place, or thing. So kings, be her love and she'll be your peace. Queens, be his peace and he'll be your love. These work hand in hand. These are men and women's drive. Y'all going to pay the stupid tax of life not respecting peace and love. I don't agree with a man cheating. I don't agree with a man walking away, leaving a woman without closure and clarity. But I do understand, because Proverbs says, action causes a reaction. I'm telling you right now, you got to be a fool to be a man to play with a woman's love. That is God's daughters. And what father won't take care of his own child? What father won't protect his own daughters? You are hindering your prayers and blocking your blessings by how you treat and handle a woman. A woman. You a dummy. You a fool. Your success has been hindered and blocked. Life is not fulfilling by how you thought you was going to treat. The more powerful key ingredient of life that fulfilled the earth, God will hold you accountable through your lack of progress. God will teach you, give you a teachable moment through your lack of progress. You wonder why you can't get ahead? You need to be conscious of how you treat the women in your life, because I always said a man's true success is contingent upon the company of women he keeps in his life and how he treats them, giving them the reverence, honor of who they are, their very existence. How can you disrespect and hurt a woman and you came through a woman? You came through that life canal, that birth canal. Even the father created the seed to create you. So them coming together, meaning you should be a man and you should know how to treat a woman. Y'all better understand that God will bring you to the front of the congregation to teach you a valuable lesson that is going to stagger you through the acts of karma, where you will have a teachable moment. I'm telling you right now, because these men, these good men, these good women that are God sent, if you don't appreciate anything that's God sent, I'm telling you right now, if you don't appreciate it, the Lord giveth and the Lord will take it away. And you will have to suffer watching that good man and that good woman being loved, enjoyed, successful, peaceful with somebody else. All because you acting a fool and you won't change. And it's going to hurt you because it's going to come in the form of karma. Karma comes to teach, but karma also will hurt you, stab you, because sometimes God will allow the pain to run so deep so you can get the lesson. The lesson that is learned turns into the blessing. Learned lessons equal high power blessing. So what is God saying? I am willing to do whatever I have to do so you can learn and turn from the error of your ways. God is no respect of any person. Some of y'all will go through so much pain. Some of y'all will go through so much disappointment. Some of y'all will go through so much weariness. Why? Because God will allow that pain to reach a certain level. That struggle to reach a certain level. That distraction to reach a certain level. So you can get the lesson. The lesson from your actions. Proverbs says an action causes a reaction. So you need to be conscious of how y'all treat each other, men and women. Because how you treat men and women will block your blessings and be of great hindrance to your self-growth, your aspirations, your goals, your blessings. It's time for a change. Come back home. You are in your past. Come back home. You were in your future. Come back home. God wants you in your nows. It's time to come back to the NOWs. I love y'all, man. I pray that any something I said have inspired y'all in some type of way. I pray that it make your chest poke out. I pray that it make your chin up. I pray that it inspire you to make some conscious choices that's going to bless your todays. Realign your mind, heart, body, and soul, because today can be one of the best days of your life. Today can be that moment where you get that phone call, that opportunity, that thing you've been waiting for. But you need to have the mind frame so you can be ready when it comes. It can come at 12 o'clock and come at 2 o'clock. You don't know. But I'm telling you, today can be one of the best days of your life with a changed mind, a changed heart, a clean soul. I am Jay Pitts Presents. I am your life coach. And class is dismissed. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Let's go.
Call, but you have to call. Yeah. My schedule too busy to be tacking on.
Yeah.
Got you babe watching like I'm hustling hard. Yeah. And ignore. Going for your missions like I grab the ball.
Yeah.
Boy, the agents paranoid, so much back and forth. I touched down in New York, Eli Manning.
Oh,
all my life, I got off on the 13th floor. Grateful for these blessings till I'm seeing plenty more. That's for sure. I'm showing it like side. Came out of mud, the diamond and rub, just give me a wipe down, yeah. Shining bright until the lights turn down. Salute me when you see me, man. Salute me when you see me, goddamn. The pain made me everything I am. Everything I got, right up to the top. The pain made me everything I am. Took everything I got, right up to the top. Ayy, you ain't got the bandwidth to handle this. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this, nah. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this, nah. Well spoken for a black man. That's how you serve a compliment with your backhand. A routine stop, ain't no talking back. Save your breath, keep it 2 cents in the best in the dash can. I've been a menace back when, sleeping on me at this mad camp. Keep it G, would you rather be a never was or a has been? I put it down with a tile on it, ain't out the wall like a house haunted. I'm looking down but I never look down on it. I put a crown on it, yeah. The kids are bad, the money is long, the head is good. The future's bright, the crown is heavy, the dash is wood grain. A long way from young, girl misunderstood. A long way from home, strong, high, still come. Showing it like side. Came out of mud, the diamond and rub, just give me a wipe down, yeah. Shining bright until the lights turn down. Salute me when you see me, man. Salute me when you see me, goddamn. The pain made me everything I am. Took everything I got, right up to the top. The pain made me everything I am. Took everything I got, right up to the top. Ayy, you ain't got the bandwidth to handle this. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this, nah. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this. You ain't got the bandwidth to handle this, nah.
Pain made me everything I am. Pain made me everything I am. Yeah. Yes, sir. I am J. Pitts Presents. I am your life coach and class dismissed. Thomas of the Essence. And it starts what? Right now. Get back to your N-O-W's. Right now. The pain made me everything I am. Let's go. Miracle Monday, Motivation Monday, Manifestation Monday.